welcome to Roving Camera. I'm Rashika Gangwani, bringing you the highlights of the events that took place in the Parliament last week. Om Birla, Speaker Lok Sabha, along with Dr. Harsh Vardhan, Union Minister for Health and Family Welfare, Shri Ashwini Kumar Chaubey, MOS, Health and Family Welfare, and Shri Anurag Singh Thakur, Minister of State for Finance, inaugurated a health awareness and check-up camp at the Parliament House that shall provide health awareness and diagnostic services to the parliamentarians and their family members.
A health awareness and check-up camp at Parliament House is being organised from 20th November to 4th December by CGHS in association with Lok Sabha Secretariat for the members of Parliament and their family members. The health exhibition and camp features different kinds of treatments. Specialists from AIIMS, Safdarjung Hospital, Dr. RML Hospital and Lady Harding Medical College and Suchita Kriplani Hospital are invited for the camp. The camp is providing specialized health services to members of Parliament. Diagnostic facilities for relevant important investigations in radiology and biochemistry are being provided at the health camp.
मुझे बहुत खुशी है कि आज हमारे स्वास्थ्य मंत्रालय ने सारे हमारे दिल्ली के जो बड़े अस्पताल हैं ऑल इंडिया इंस्टीट्यूट आरएमएल हॉस्पिटल सफदरजंग हॉस्पिटल लेडी हार्डिंग मेडिकल कॉलेज और पूरा का पूरा सीजीएचएस उनके सबके डॉक्टर्स ने मिलकर अपने माननीय लोकसभा के स्पीकर उनके नेतृत्व में हमने आज यहां पार्लियामेंट हाउस एनेक्स में आज से शुरू करके 4 दिसंबर तक सारे पार्लियामेंट मेंबर्स लोकसभा और राज्यसभा के और उनके सभी परिवारजन उनके लिए कंप्लीट थॉरो मेडिकल चेकअप सब प्रकार के टेस्ट स्पेशलिस्ट सुपर स्पेशलिस्ट आयुर्वेदा सिद्धा यूनानी होम्योपैथी योगा ये सारी चीज़ों की यहाँ पर सुविधा क्रिएट की है हम चाहते हैं कि हमारे सारे पार्लियामेंट मेंबर्स समय निकालकर इस पार्लियामेंट के सत्र के दौरान अपने परिवार के साथ यहाँ पर आएँ सुबह से लेकर और शाम तक ये सारी व्यवस्था खुली रहेगी और अपना स्वास्थ्य का जाँच कराएँ भगवान ना करे कोई कमी निकले तो उसका इलाज कराएं और पूरी तरह से स्वस्थ होने की प्रक्रिया की शुरुआत करके 100 वर्ष तक जीने का अभियान चलाएं।
A program of National Summit for Every Child in India was organized by UNICEF in the Parliament House Annexe to mark 30 years of United Nations Convention on Rights of the Child. Vice President of India and Chairman Rajya Sabha M. Venkaiah Naidu was the chief guest at the function. Speaking on the occasion, the Vice President called the steps to empower and equip children to make them agents of change and transformation leaders of the future.
India celebrates commitment to child rights with National Summit for Every Child in India at Parliament on the World's Children's Day. Addressing the National Summit for Every Child in India, organized by UNICEF in Parliament to mark 30 years of UNCRC, Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu said a positive start has indeed been made by the Right to Education Act 2009. But it is not sufficient to just provide any education. We must have quality education. We must have affordable, relevant education. We must have education that empowers children with the competencies of the 21st century. He also said that it was the duty of the government's educational institutions, civil society and parents to build a safe, secure, just and fair world for our future generation.
We are a civilization, India, which believes in Vasudhaika Kutumbakam. The entire world is one family. Share and care is the core of Indian philosophy. So we must first take care of our children, take care of the children who are unfortunate of not having a good economic support. We should focus on them and then try to uplift them on our priority as per our philosophy of Antyodaya, uplifting the suppressed, oppressed and depressed people, taking care of the last person on the queue, at the line. We should give priority more and more in the coming days. I hope that more and more organizations will join that and members of Parliament in their respective areas, identify such institutions or such organizations and give them all encouragement to their activities. To neglect children is to neglect our country's and planet's well-being. Not only our country's, planet's well-being. because as I said, we believe in Vasudhaika Kutumbakam. To not to take action in time is also to imperil our own future. We cannot afford to have any more missed opportunities. To take a solemn resolve today as lawmakers and citizens that we will continue our crusade to evolve the implement meaningful child-centered policies and programs. We have to shape our tomorrow today. We have to shape our tomorrow today. We have to ensure that our future through our healthy, energetic, inquisitive children.
On 19th of November, Haryana Chief Minister Manohar Lal Khattar met Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla at his residence in New Delhi. This was a part of the courtesy visit.
In the meeting between the Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla and the Chief Minister of Haryana, Manohar Lal Khattar, various issues related to the Haryana were discussed.
On 24th of November, the Pravanand International School of the Bharat Sevastam celebrated its 5th Foundation Day. On the occasion, a ceremony was organized at the PIS school premises in Gurugram. Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla was the chief guest at the event.
The Pravanand International School of the Bharat Seva Samsthan celebrated its 5th Foundation Day with unprecedented fanfare on November 24th at the school premises. The school was decorated elegantly for the event. Many talented students of the school presented a mesmerizing show of the cultural events. Addressing the present audience on the occasion, the chief guest, Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla, lauded and praised the Pravanand International School for raising the educational standard in the Gurugram city as well as for their role in raising awareness for social and nationalistic causes among the youth.
Bharat Sevashram Dara is desh mein nahi, vishv ke kai deshon ke andar shiksha, आध्यात्मिक ज्ञान चिकित्सा जैसे पुनित कार्य को लंबे समय से किया जा रहा है इस संघ की द्वारा स्वामी जी के विचारों के माध्यम से इस देश में नहीं पूरे विश्व के अंदर समाज जीवन के अंदर लोगों में परिवर्तन हो सामाजिक आर्थिक और सांस्कृतिक और नैतिक उत्थान के लिए लगातार इस संघ के द्वारा काम किया जा रहा है ये संघ एक धर्मनिरपेक्ष गैर सांप्रदायिक गैर राजनीतिक और सार्वभौमिक अभियान के रूप में लगातार पिछले 103 वर्षों से देश और विश्व के कई क्षेत्रों में काम चल रहा है पूरे भारत में इसकी 100 शाखाएं हैं और भारत के बाहर भी इसकी 23 शाखाएं इस पुण्य कार्य के लिए कर रही है इस संघ लंबी अवधि से सामाजिक आर्थिक राजनीति परिप्रेक्ष्य में समाज जीवन में कैसे परिवर्तन हो सकता है इसके लिए एक विशेष काम कर रहा है और इसीलिए विदेशों में भी सामाजिक सेवाओं के काम करने के कारण एक इसकी विशेष पहचान बनी है अस्पताल हो पॉलिटेक्निक कॉलेज हो चल चिकित्सा इकाई हो औषधालय हो धर्मशाला हो हॉस्टल हो रोजगार मुखी कार्यक्रम हो व्यवसाय प्रशिक्षण केंद्र हो और सबसे बड़ा काम आपदा के समय संकट के समय इस देश में नहीं पूरे विश्व में जहां जहां भी आपदा आई इस संघ के लोग उन सरकारों से पहले वहां की जनता की सेवा के लिए पहुंचे हैं इतना पुनित कार्य कर रहे हैं और लगातार एक तरफ शिक्षा के माध्यम से अच्छी शिक्षा संस्कार देने का काम कर रहे हैं। वहाँ पर देश और विश्व के अंदर कई जगह हॉस्पिटल खोलकर चिकित्सा जैसा पुनित कार्य भी कर रहे हैं। चिकित्सा का पुनित कार्य केवल एक हॉस्पिटल नहीं, चल चिकित्सा इकाई के माध्यम से भी इस संघ के लोग लगातार कर रहे हैं। और दूर दराज इलाके के अंदर जहाँ चिकित्सा नहीं पहुँची, जहाँ चिकित्सा का अभाव है, उन क्षेत्रों में विशेष रूप से चिकित्सा जैसा पुनित कार्य कर जनसेवा का काम कर रहे हैं। और इतना ही नहीं, उन जनजाति इलाकों के अंदर, उन आदिवासी इलाकों के अंदर जहाँ अभी भी सरकार शिक्षा के मंदिर नहीं खोल पाई, हॉस्पिटल नहीं खोल पाई, वहाँ के बच्चों को वैश्विक शिक्षा देकर, रोजगार शिक्षा देकर लगातार इस संघ द्वारा एक लंबे समय से काम कर रहा है। और ये विद्यालय कई खुलते हैं, एक पुण्य का काम, जहाँ शिक्षा भी हो, संस्कार भी हो, अच्छे विचार भी हो, आध्यात्मिक ज्ञान भी हो, जिसके माध्यम से एक नए समाज का निर्माण कर सके। क्योंकि इन बच्चों में हम अच्छे शिक्षा देंगे, संस्कार देंगे, आध्यात्मिक ज्ञान देंगे, तो एक नए भारत का निर्माण करने का काम करेंगे। और नए भारत का निर्माण करना है तो हमें एक ऐसी पीढ़ी तैयार करनी है जो केवल शिक्षित न हो, संस्कार भी हो और आध्यात्मिक ज्ञान भी हो। इसलिए मैं देखता हूँ कि लगातार यहाँ के शामिल लोग किस तरीके से लगातार काम कर रहे हैं।
We'll take a short break here and be right back on the other side. Welcome back to Roving Camera, a program that brings you the highlights of the events that took place in the Parliament last week. On 21st of November, the Parliamentary Research and Training Institute for Democracies, Lok Sabha Secretariat, organized an orientation program for the elected members of the 17th Lok Sabha in the main committee room of the Parliament Library Building in New Delhi. Minister of State for External Affairs and Ministry of State for Parliamentary Affairs V. Muralidharan and Chairperson of the Parliamentary Committee on Information Technology and former Minister of State for External Affairs Shashi Tharoor delivered lecture on parliamentary diplomacy.
A democratic polity offers equal opportunity to all its citizens to get elected to the legislature if he or she fulfills the criteria laid down for the purpose. It is likely that a member of parliament elected for the first time may not be very familiar with the intricacies of the parliamentary law, practice and procedure. With a view to familiarizing the newly elected members with the working of the Lok Sabha, the Parliamentary Research and Training Institute for Democracies organizes orientation program after the constitution of a new Lok Sabha after the general elections. These orientation programs are aimed at providing a deeper understanding and appreciation of the constitutional role and position of the Parliament as the supreme representative institution, familiarizing the members more closely with the operational mechanisms, parliamentary traditions, conventions and etiquette. Addressing the newly elected members of the Parliament on parliamentary diplomacy, Minister of State for External Affairs and Ministry of Parliamentary Affairs V. Muralidharan said parliamentary diplomacy is an institutionalized device that is available to the members of parliament to protect and promote national interest and also to provide a parliamentary dimension to international negotiations.
India has carved a special space for itself in the Committee of Nations today. We have also come to achieve the feat of the fastest growing emerging market economy in the world, as also a recognition as a country with excellent business opportunities and investment. Supplementing the efforts of our leadership in making India a global power, I do not have an iota of doubt that parliamentary diplomacy has an important role to play. Traditionally, the role of the legislature in foreign policy decision making has been limited to the instruments of holding the executive to account, that is budgetary control and scrutiny of executive action by means of parliamentary committees.
Chairperson of the Parliamentary Committee on Information Technology, Shashi Tharoor, said that parliamentary diplomacy is taking forward our diplomatic outreach, supplementing the efforts of our leadership and our professional diplomats in expanding the global footprints of India.
Parliamentary diplomacy is actually an exercise of our constitutional responsibility. Now, in practice, this takes myriad forms. I'll broadly classify them in four. One is what one may call parliament to parliament, simple cooperation between parliaments. That's regular exchanges of traveling delegations of MPs. We are in a slightly different position from other countries, and many of you will know that many countries send their external affairs or foreign affairs committees on foreign trips to other countries as part of the goodwill exercise. So when I was chairman of the External Affairs Committee of our parliament for the last 5 years, I must have received 20, 25 different delegations from different countries and indeed from one supranational entity, the European Union. And their committee would come, but always, I'm afraid, we could not reciprocate despite their invitation, because our policy is that only the speaker leads delegations abroad and no committee travels abroad. So the speaker will lead a parliamentary delegation and will take with him a representative sprinkling of MPs from different parties to accompany him and have the experience with him, but it is not the External Affairs Committee, it is the speaker who travels. A second example would be delegations of MPs. Some of these can be appointed in rare cases by the speaker himself. Sometimes they are created by think tanks and NGOs, CII, the Confederation of Indian Industry, the Aspen Institute, Ananta Center. Such groups have a habit of inviting MPs to go on a trip under their auspices, but as MPs, and to have meetings with MPs on the other side to various countries. It's sometimes referred to as track two diplomacy. That is, track one is the official diplomacy of governments. Track two involves civil society. And in particular, in this variant, it is MPs and legislators who are going and visiting other countries. I've been on a couple of these delegations. Some of you may have also been invited to do that. Then there are friendship groups. That is, every parliament normally sets up a friendship group between its MPs and another country's MPs. A friendship group is an informal group. It has no constitutional standing. But let us say an MP comes to the speaker and says, I'd like to start a friendship group with Russia, for example. The speaker would authorize a certain number of MPs to join this MP, and they would be recognized as a friendship group, and they would in turn have friendly interactions with the embassy of that country and sometimes with visiting delegations from that country.
The Commonwealth Parliamentary Association is a unique association of parliaments and parliamentarians across 185 parliaments and legislators with about 17,000 members. India is among the foremost and active members of the Commonwealth Parliamentary Association. The annual core program of the Commonwealth Parliamentary Association, the Commonwealth Youth Parliament, rotates alphabetically through the regions of the Commonwealth. The 10th Commonwealth Youth Parliament is being held in New Delhi. Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla was the chief guest at the inaugural function.
More than 50 young people from 24 Commonwealth countries, as well as young members of parliament from the CPA India region and other CPA branches, participated in the 10th Commonwealth Youth Parliament. It is an opportunity for young people from the Commonwealth to experience aspects of parliamentary democracy and provides a platform for them to establish links with like-minded people. The delegates will participate in mock proceedings of the parliamentary system, discussing several current issues. Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla inaugurated the 10th Commonwealth Youth Parliament at the Delhi Assembly on November 25 and said that global participants will get a chance to closely understand democracy in India. Speaking at the inaugural session, Birla said that the participants hailing from different countries will get an opportunity to understand the world's largest democracy from their perspective.
Hamare aane wali peedhi ke andar kis tarike se loktantra मजबूत हो उनके जीवन में लोकतंत्र प्रजातंत्र मजबूत हो इसके लिए हमें प्रयास करने की ज़रूरत है और इसीलिए भविष्य में लोकतंत्र मजबूत करने के लिए इसी राष्ट्रमंडल समूह ने CIP की परिकल्पना की है। साथियों, साइंस और टेक्नोलॉजी के इस नए युग में पूरी दुनिया ने हमें सबको निकट लाने का प्रयास किया। पूरा विश्व एक आज ग्लोबल विलेज बन चुका है। इस परिस्थिति में विश्व के हर देश की प्रगति और समृद्धि के साथ साथ सबका भविष्य भी एक दूसरे के साथ जुड़ा हुआ है। इसलिए न केवल देश के भीतर बल्कि अंतर्राष्ट्रीय स्तर पर भी लोकतांत्रिक प्रणाली और लोकतांत्रिक मूल्यों को अधिक से अधिक बढ़ावा देकर सशक्त बनाने की आवश्यकता है। इसके लिए विश्व में ये नई पीढ़ी किस तरीके से हमारे लोकतांत्रिक वैल्यू के प्रति जागरूक हो, उनमें विश्वास पैदा हो और किस तरीके से हम लोकतांत्रिक संस्थाओं को और उनकी पद्धतियों को और मजबूत करने का काम करें, और इसके लिए ये युवा संसद निश्चित रूप से एक क्रिएटिव डायनेमिक मंच होगी जो इसके लिए सतत प्रयासों की ओर बढ़ेगी। साथियों, जीवन के किसी भी क्षेत्र में कुछ बेहतर करने के लिए ये जरूरी है कि हम उस क्षेत्र की परंपराओं से, तौर तरीकों से परिचित हों, हम उनकी बारीकियों, उनकी खूबियों और कमियों को जानें। CYP की यही प्रयास है कि आम युवाओं को संसदीय कार्यप्रणाली से साक्षात रूप से जोड़ा जाए। आप सबका इस गौरवपूर्ण आयोजन में शामिल होना इस बात का गवाही देता है कि आप संसदीय लोकतंत्र और राजनीति में रुचि रखते हैं। इसलिए आपको इस अवसर का लाभ भी उठाना चाहिए और अपने ज्ञान व अनुभव को समृद्ध करने की कोशिश करना चाहिए। साथियों, हम सबको ये समझना चाहिए कि संसदीय लोकतंत्र की मूल भावना क्या है, इसकी प्रेरक शक्ति क्या है। इसकी मूल भावना है डायलॉग की, डिबेट की और डिसीजन की। हम समावेशी तरीके से सोचने, विचारने की और लोकतंत्र शासन की एक प्रणाली को मजबूत करने का काम करें। लेकिन उससे पहले लोकतंत्र में, डिसीजन मेकिंग में आप सबका समावेशी प्रयास होना चाहिए।
चीफ मिनिस्टर अरविंद केजरीवाल आस्क्ड द पार्टिसिपेंट्स टू फाइंड वेज टू कनेक्ट द गवर्नमेंट टू पीपल एट ग्रास रूट्स एंड इंक्रीज पब्लिक पार्टिसिपेशन इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ पब्लिक पॉलिसीज।
टुडे एज वी नो वी कीप ऑन हियरिंग अबाउट प्रेसिडेंशियल फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नेंस। इंडिया हैज अ पार्लियामेंट्री फॉर्म ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी एंड वेरियस अदर कंट्रीज हैव अ मिक्स ऑफ द टू और वेरियस different forms of these two forms of governance, but in a way both of them are indirect forms of democracy where people elect their representatives once in 5 years and the representatives enjoy all the executive powers and legislative powers to govern the people. The people have very little direct say in governance in the next 5 years. I would like to put this question before you, that when you are attending this in the next 2 or 3 days, do keep this in mind, that can we evolve, can the democracy evolve to a stage where we have some kind of direct form of democracy? Where in the next 5 years after electing a representative, can the people have some kind of direct control over their representatives, over the government functions, over the government functionaries, over the government funds? Can the people have some kind of a say in governance in the next 5 years? This is one question that keeps bothering me. And this is something that we would like, it'll be interesting if you could think about it and let us have our feedback.
Commonwealth Parliamentary Association Chairman Emilia Monjova Lifaka thanked the government for hosting the delegates, calling the event an opportunity to understand the Indian democracy. Lifaka's thought found resonance in several delegates who called the event very special for them.
India is the largest democracy in the world. At the 2019 elections, a breathtaking 600 million people voted. Furthermore, As we celebrate the 70th anniversary of the London Declaration and the foundation of the modern Commonwealth, it is important to consider the significant role that the newly founded State of India played. Drafted by the Indian statesman V.K. Krishan Menon, the Declaration had two main provisions. It allowed the Commonwealth to admit and retain members that were dominions, so including both republics and indigenous monarchies. And it changed the name of the organization from the British Commonwealth to the Commonwealth of Nations. It is therefore appropriate that this year's Commonwealth Youth Parliament should be here in India. India, which has one of the fastest growing economies in the world today, is home to a fifth of the world's youth. Half of its population is under the age of 25, and a quarter is below the age of 14. India's young population is its most valuable asset. As such, India has long recognized the importance of young people to the future of society.
Parliamentarians paid floral tribute to former Speaker Rabi Ray on his birth anniversary. We get you all the details.
Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla, Deputy Chairman Rajya Sabha Hari Vansh, Minister of State for Parliamentary Affairs V. Muralidharan, and Secretary General of Lok Sabha Snehlata Srivastav paid floral tributes at the portrait of former Lok Sabha Speaker Rabi Ray on his birth anniversary at a function held in Parliament House.
On 26th of November, Om Birla, Speaker Lok Sabha, planted a red sandalwood tree in the Parliament House complex.
Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla marked the 70th Constitution Day by planting a red sandalwood tree in the Parliament House complex. On this occasion, several members of Parliament, Secretary General Lok Sabha and senior officials of the Secretariat were also present. Small steps such as planting of trees may turn into a big leap towards the environmental protection and for the benefit of the country, preserving our environment for the posterity.
With that, we have come to the end of this edition of Roving Camera. Join me next week for all the news in and around Parliament. Keep watching Lok Sabha Television.